Hello students, you are welcome back to your own channel, Let's Learn Science. Today in this session we will talk about the complex permanent tissue. Already we have learned about meristematic tissue and its various types. Then we have learned about semi-permanent tissue as well as its various types, that is about parenchyma, collenchyma, sclerenchyma, their function, the location of those tissue in the plant body. So far we have across those things in the last session. So if you have not watched the video, then it is available in the playlist, so you can watch it from there. So let us talk today about the complex permanent tissue. Complex permanent tissue. From the name itself, complex. While reading about simple permanent tissue, what we come to know? That they are made up of single types of cell. They are made up of what? Single types of cell. But in case of complex permanent tissue, they are made up of different cells, but all the cells have the common origin. What they have? They are different types. They are made up of complex permanent tissue. Complex permanent tissue is made up of different types of cells, but all cells have a common origin. They originated from the common place. Right? So that type of tissue is termed as what you know, complex permanent tissue. And why it is permanent? Already we come to know that it is to lose the capacity of dividing. And it is to, after dividing tissues is to, when the dividing tissue is, you know, divide the different parts of the plant body for a different growth resulted as well as particle. So after that, they used to take a permanent shape, size, as well as function in the plant body, and they used to become permanent. So from that one also, you know, they are permanent, that is, they lose the capacity of dividing. Next, all cells coordinate to form. So the different cells combine together and they have a common origin, and they, what happened, they coordinate to perform a common function in the plant body, and they are responsible to carry out a common function in the body of the plant. Coordinate, they used to help each other, each and every cell is used to help each other, and they used to perform what, you know, a common function in the plant body. It transport, and the complex permanent tissue is mainly responsible to transport water, then mineral salt. It is to transport water, mineral salt, and what, you know, food material. What material? Food material. It is to transport water, mineral salt, and food material to different parts of the body of the plant. One type of tissue, one type of complex permanent tissue is that is responsible to carry the water as well as mineral salt from the soil with the help of roots, as well as with the help of the particular type of complex permanent tissue to the leaf of the plant, so that it can carry out the photosynthesis. Again, the food that is prepared in the leaf by the process of photosynthesis, that have to be transported to the different parts of the body. So like this way, the complex permanent tissue is mainly responsible for the transportation of water, mineral salt, and food material to different parts of the body. It is of how many types? Two types. It is of two types, that is xylem and phloem. It is of how many types? Two types, xylem and phloem. Right. So both of these xylem and phloem are what is a conducting tissue, and they are known as vascular tissue. They are also called what? Vascular tissue, and together both of them constitute vascular bundles. And together both of them means here xylem and phloem. Xylem and phloem constitute a vascular bundle in the plant body. Now we will learn about the function as well as the different cells that is to build up the xylem and phloem in the plant while forming the complex permanent tissue, as well as their function in detail one by one. Now let's see the function of xylem and phloem as well as their composition. Let's see. So now let's see the composition of xylem and function of xylem, which is a complex permanent tissue. Just now we have read. It is composed of four different cells or elements. By how many types of cell the xylem is used to made up? It is made up of 4 different cells, or that one also called as elements. That is, xylem is composed of 4 types of cell. And what are they? They are truss, vessels, xylem parenchyma, and xylem sclerenchyma. What are the cells that are composed in xylem? Or xylem is composed of what types of cells? That are trusses, vessels, then xylem parenchyma and xylem sclerenchyma. These 4 cells constitute what? Xylem. And out of these 4 cells, only xylem parenchyma is made up of what, you know? Living cell. Living cell. Other, that is trusses, vessels and xylem sclerenchyma are bounded by dead cell wall. That is, they are lignified. They have a cell wall which is lignified by the dead cells. What is it? That is, trusses, vessels and xylem, in xylem sclerenchyma, they have a lignified wall. They have a what? Lignified wall. And that is made up of what, you know, dead cells. Now let's see the function of xylem. The main function of xylem is to carry water and mineral salt upward from the soil with the help of roots, from the root to the different parts of the shoot. That is, it is to carry the water as well as mineral salt from the root parts to the shoot, that is to the aerial parts of the plants. So let me say, it is to transfer water and mineral salt from the root to the shoot of the plant, to the aerial parts of the plants. Besides that, also it is to perform another function, as I told you, the trusses and vessels, then xylem sclerenchyma, they have a lignified cell wall. So because of that, having what, you know, lignified cell wall, they used to give the mechanical strength to the plant body. That means they used to support the plant mechanically. They used to provide the mechanical strength to the plant. Now let us see the function of pulley. So like that of xylem, pulley, which is also a complex permanent tissue, and it is also made up of 4 types of cells, or I can say elements. That is, the pulley also consists of 4 cells. That it is to made up of with the help of 4 cells or elements. Let's see what are these. The first cell that is found in the pulley is sieve tube. What it is? Sieve tube. Then companion cells. What cells? Companion cells. Then pulley parenchyma and pulley fibers. So it is made up of sieve tube, companion cells, pulley parenchyma and pulley fibers. So pulley is used to made up of these 4, with the help of these 4 types of cells. That is, sieve tube, companion cells, pulley parenchyma and pulley fibers. Now let's see the function of pulley. What function it is to perform in the plant body? It transports the prepared food. The food that is prepared in the leaf of the plant. So it is to transfer those prepared food material from the leaves to the different storage region where the food have to be stored. Suppose some food have to be stored in the roots, some food have to be stored in the stem. So in different parts of the plant, the food is used to store for future use. So pulley is used to transport the prepared food material from leaf to the region of storage, and then to the, and after that, from the storage reason it is to what it is coulomb is used to transport the food material to the different growing region or to the different parts of the plant. So like this way, what it then the coulomb is used to help in the transportation of food material in the plant body. So what we have learned today in this session, let us revise. We have learned about what you know complex permanent tissue. That complex permanent, why it is called complex permanent tissue? Because it is made up of different types of cells, but all cells have the same or common origin. And we have got that you know the main function of the complex permanent tissue is to transport that various types of material into the plant body. Then we have come to know about the different types of complex permanent tissue, that is xylem and phloem. Xylem is also made up of four cells, that is trusses, vessels, then xylem parenchyma and xylem sclerenchyma. And we have come across the function of what is the xylem. It is to transport the water, then mineral salt, as well as what is the it is xylem is mainly responsible to transport the water and mineral salt from root to the shoot of the plant. That is, it is to transport water as well as mineral salt from the root to the aerial parts of the plants. Then we come to know about what you know phloem, which is also a complex permanent tissue, and it is also made up of what you know four types of cell or elements, that is sieve tube, then companion cells, then phloem parenchyma, as well as phloem fibers. And its main function is to transport the prepared food material from the leaf to the storage region of in the plant, and then from the storage region to different growing parts of the plant, as well as to various parts of the plants. So like this, these two complex permanent tissue, that is xylem and phloem, is used to carry out different type of transportation function in the plant body, and that's why they are termed as what you know conducting tissue, or they are also called vascular tissue, and both of them combine together and to form a vascular bundle in the plant body. So today all you know we have tried our level best to learn about the complex permanent tissue, and today's session is up to this much. With this I want to end up the session. So if you like the video, then please comment, subscribe and share. Thank you.